appear righteous unto men, but within you are full of hypocrisy and iniquity. Now, Jesus now took us along the Ten Commandments. Jesus said that to love God supremely is the first and the greatest commandment. As we have read in Matthew 22, 38. It is the first and greatest in that it represents the heartbeat of every one of the commandments. But while it is the first commandment, it is not the only one. As Jesus quoting from the second of the Ten Commandments also said, if you love me, keep my commandments. John 14, 15. He did not say, if you obey me, then you will love me. Obedience does not lead to love, but love does lead to obedience. Amen. The more we know God, the more we love him. Amen. And the more we love him, the more it becomes a delight to serve him. Hallelujah. And do his will. Amen. 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 So if we truly love God, we will keep all the other commandments as well as the greatest, which comprises them all. So, does loving God with all your heart, your soul, and mind change or abolish any of the Ten Commandments? Not at all. So what is actually taking place in this passage? It comes about as a result of a lawyer attempting to outsmart Jesus. This does not mean that this so-called lawyer practiced law, but was one who was learned or skilled in the law of Moses. Mark calls him one of the scribes, which means the same thing. We see in verse 34 that the Pharisees had heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees. So this lawyer now makes an attempt to trap Jesus by asking him, which is the most important commandment? And Jesus cleverly responds by quoting the Old Commandment, the Old Testament, as he frequently does. Here is the full passage in contention, Matthew 22:34-40. But when the Pharisees had heard that he had put the Sadducees to silence, they were gathered together. Then one of them, which was a lawyer, asked him a question, tempting him, and saying, Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Jesus said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and the great commandment. And the second is like unto it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. So Jesus summed up the law by breaking it into the following two groups. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all your soul and with all your entire mind. Those are the first four laws in the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself, the last six. Because if you remember, we have Ten Commandments in the tablet. The first four referring to God, and the remaining last six referring to our neighbor. Since the first four commandments relate to loving God with all our heart, soul, and mind, then they are about our duty and love to God. But that leads to the question, if the first four commandments are about our love for God, then why have many so discarded the fourth commandment, which also defines our love and duty to our Heavenly Father? So when Jesus said, all the law hangs on these two commandments, he did not mean some of it as in nine commandments or none of it as a zero commandment. When Jesus said all the law, that is exactly what he meant. I assume we are all familiar with Ten Commandments, and that's why we have read it this morning. But did we see the Ten Commandments as Jesus saw it? Now let us see Jesus grouping the Ten Commandments into the first four relating to God and the last is relating to our neighbor, as we read in Exodus chapter 20, which Angel has read to us. So you go with me again, Exodus chapter 20. Can you open it? Exodus chapter 20. So if you're going through it, you shall have no other gods before me. That is Exodus chapter 20, verse 3. In view of his sovereignty and goodness, we are commanded to have no other gods before Jehovah. Then two, you shall not make for yourself a carved image. Exodus 20, verse 4. The first and the second commandments go hand in hand, both emphasizing the need to give our worship exclusively to the one true God. The Israelites violated this commandment and crafted their own graven image, a golden calf, even before Moses came down from the mountain. And three, you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, which is verse 7. To take God's name in vain is to use it in an empty and meaningless way, because there is no other name under the heaven given among men by which we must be saved. We must be careful to instead treat the name of God with honor and reverence, as Apostle Paul told us in Acts 4, verse 12. And then 4, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Exodus 8, 20, verse 8. It's in wisdom and grace God commanded his people to observe a weekly day of rest. The Sabbath was to be observed in imitation of God's own work in creation, as we read in Exodus 20:11, as well as his redemptive work in Deuteronomy 5:15. And then 5, honor your father and your mother. Exodus 20:12. The fifth commandment is reiterated by the Apostle Paul, who described it as the first commandment with promise, as we've read in Ephesians 6, 2. Honoring God means honoring the authority he has placed in our lives. And what is the promise if we honor not only our biological fathers, but all those old enough to be our fathers or mothers? Verse 3 says that it may be well with you, and you may live long on earth. Many youths are perishing today, unfortunately, while young people are being denied old age because they no longer have respect or regard for elders. Old age cannot be acquired or purchased with money, as their wisdom and experiences were collected over a long span of a life full of ups and downs, sufferings, trials, and successes, and strong faith to just keep going until it is finished. Let us therefore take care of our old parents and learn from them. And that reminds me of an adage. A child may have latest clothes in the closet, but he can never have more rags, that is old clothes, than the elder, than his father. And those rags are wisdom, their experience, and accommodating heart. Amen. 6, you shall not murder. Exodus 20:13. The taking of human life is expressly forbidden. Jesus elaborates on this commandment in the Sermon on the Mount, revealing that the sin of murder begins in the heart. Matthew 5:21-22. You have heard that it was said to those of old, you shall not murder, and whoever murders will be in danger of the judgment. But I say to you, that whoever is angry with his brother without a cause shall be in danger of the judgment. And whoever says to his brother, Raca, shall be in danger of the council. But whoever says, you fool, shall be in danger of hellfire. And 7, you shall not commit adultery. Verse 14, the sanctity of marriage is given noteworthy attention throughout scripture. Christ reminds us in Matthew 5:27-30 that the marriage relationship must be guarded diligently. And Jesus does explain, you have heard that it was said, you shall not commit adultery. But I tell you that anyone who looks at a woman lustfully has already committed adultery with her in his heart. If your right eye causes you to stumble, gouge it out and throw it away.